Say good morning. Yes, it's us. It's us today. Me and my young man. Me and my Buddha. Today's Friday, January 21st, 22nd. The girls is back in school. Buddha go back to school. Her next week, physical school. So he got to do virtual at 12 o'clock with me while I work. It's only a half an hour. I'm not going to skip today. It's just balls. Highlight of my day. Being with my baby boy. You know, eat him pancakes. Him eat him pancakes. And he gonna go to sleep just like that right there. Go to sleep so he can go to sleep. My struggle is real. Okay. This is my why. This is why I have to lose the weight. This is why I gotta prove my pride of worth. This is why I gotta show and prove that I'm determined and that I'm ready to win. This is it right here. So I can spend more moments with them, well, with all of my kids, and just be more mobile and home, you know? Flexible, you know? Instead of just always being out here all the time. It's a struggle. I'm one of the candidates that's not vaccinated. So I can't work. And with my kids' schedule the way it was a while ago, I couldn't have worked anyway. I lost my job in July. I left two jobs to be with one job because it paid more than both jobs combined. And I lost it. It's all good though, because self-employment is teaching me a lot. And it's a struggle, I swear it is. Being by yourself and you can't even rely on the other parent, or you not having family members because they're deceased, you know, the ones that you know that will take care of you, not take care of you, but like always gonna be there for you, know that they got you no matter what. I don't have a support system like everybody else do. A lot of people got godparents and stuff and all that other shit. I don't got none of that. None of that. It's just me and my kids. So nobody knows the struggle. It's just me and my damn kids. And my damn wheels. Self-employment. My determination is to get off of government assistance because I'm sick of them heckling me and always on my ass about, you know, income and stuff. I report my income and they increase my rent portion because I'm on Section 8. But they won't consider my car as an expense that I pay. I guess they look at it like, oh, well, you can work at a regular job. That is true. And catch the bus or get an Uber or a Lyft. But my job is this car. This car, and this car pays this car. This car pays the rest of the bills too. So, like, you're not considering this as an expense for me. But yet, when I make the money to make this payment on this damn car, you understand what I'm saying? Now you want to reduce my food stamps because you're looking at me as like, oh, I got income. How? How do I got income? If you keep snatching it. So I'm tired of that part. I don't like the picking and choosing, giving me and then taking, giving and taking. I don't like that shit at all. Don't play with me. I'm not a fucking kid. Like, this ain't no fucking treat to be on Section 8 government assistance. Like, who fucking wants to be on this shit for the rest of their life? My daughter be 17 years old. 17 this year. 17. Okay, that's a big deal. The reason why I'm saying 17 like that is because that's how long I've been on public assistance since she's been in my stomach. That's how long I've been on that shit. I'm not going for 20 years. Okay? I'm not going for 20 years. And then housing. I've been on that shit since 2004. 2004, living with my mother. Started off with living with my mother. She got approved for housing. Okay? 2004. Up until now. It's 22. I'm not going for 20 years. I'm not going for 20 years. It stops this year. That's it. I'm getting me my first home. I'm moving to a new location. I'm getting me a brand new car. And that's it. Period. Like, I'm tired of missing out on my kids, bruh. I had a situation that happened with two of my kids. I got three kids. Two of my kids last year, and I'm telling you, I just, and being that I was not able to be there, it's like, it's frustrating. So this is my why. This is my fucking why. I want to be home doing hair and, you know, I can't, I don't even have the strength to do hair anymore. To do my girl's hair and do my son's hair. You know, I'm not about to keep cutting, get his shit cut for $20 just so he can keep growing every time. And I'm going to grow his shit out. His shit damn near long enough to do twists. But I don't have the time to do it. I can't even pay nobody to do it. I don't know nobody out here in this state. I don't know nobody that know how to do twists. So I'm like, I'm frustrated. Especially the part that I don't have no support system. They father, not the bashing right here, but like, they father on some bullshit. Like, at the end of the day, this nigga, and I don't want to talk about his business, he considered substance more than he considered getting up, getting a job. And then he sent me one payment one time, and now he want a fucking reward. Like, I don't even have you on child support, dude. Like, I don't have you on child support. How the fuck you feeling some type of way? Because I took some of the money to spend on this car that I use for these kids. Like, bruh, you gotta be kidding me. When I sent you money, you spent it on yourself for the substance and yourself. You spent it on my child and your children. And I have no problems with that. And I don't never have problems with him spending money on his kids. Or if I spend money on his kids, that's never an issue. But when you spend it on substance and then you want to fucking complain about what the fuck I do with your $300, as if I ain't never gave the kids nothing, what you think a child support gonna do? Child support to... I'm not a fan of child support too much. Because, like, at the end of the day, you don't really get that much from child support. Like, these are bills. These one collectively, every last one of them are bills added on to something, you know? They want new phones. They want, new gadgets, and I can't afford it. That's a bill. My daughter plays games a lot. That's a bill, you know? That's like... You know, she do Hulu, Netflix. That's subscriptions and stuff like that. That's a bill. So, you miss me with that shit. I'm giving you a break by not going to the state in the state and not welfare. But we're not going to them and telling him, hey, he need to go get a job. I need him to get on child support right now. You know? You're lucky I'm not going for sole custody, which I am considering. Because you don't do shit for these kids. And I'm okay with that. That's the thing. I'm okay with that. See, I'm different. I'm complaining about not having a support system. But at the end of the day, let me tell you something. I got a plan. My plan right now is to get to $1 million. At least one this year. And the reason why I'm saying that about making it to $1 million this year is because cryptocurrency is a new wave right now. Okay? Cryptocurrency is a new wave. And I'm feeding it because it's so fucking low. I mean, it's so low right now. Like, it's down there, all the way at the bottom. Like, baby, wow, come on now. Like, so get the fuck out of here. Like, I'm feeding that shit. I got 28 million so far with one, okay? Then I got a few other millions and another. Like, I'm not playing. You have this energy, it's arrogancy and stuff like that. Okay, cool. When I get the millions, either I get a million for my product that I sell, or I'm going to get millions from my motherfucking cryptocurrency. Either way it goes, you better have that motherfucking same energy. That's why I'm not pressed about you or anybody else that got something to say. It's always one of the family members that be dick riding his ass, but they ain't helping his ass. That always got something to say. I wish the fuck a bitch would.